Hello and welcome, my dear students. In our previous video, we have discussed the first part of this lesson, the All-American Slur, which is written by Lenzi Nemioka. I have told you to do the warm-up activity. I hope you all must have done it. And I have also told you about the writer. And I have explained you half of the lesson. So now we have already discussed about the first dinner where Leans were invited by Gleasons and how embarrassed they felt at the dinner because of the different culture of both these countries. So now let's see what happened the next day. The next day, Meg and I got on the school bus together. I wasn't sure how she would feel about me after the spectacle our family made at the party. So next day, as usual, both of them entered into the school bus to go to school. And now Lenzi was not sure what Meg will say because of the spectacle. Spectacle means unusual event that attract the attention. Now what was the unusual event? That they were pulling out the string of celery and they were eating it. That was the unusual event for all the Americans. So here now, Lenzi was not sure what Meg is going to say about it. But she was just the same as usual, and the only reference she made to the party was thanks for coming last night. But Meg's behavior was as usual. She did not behave weird. And the only reference she gave about the party was to thank her for attending the party. Meg thanked Lenzi for attending the dinner party. Hope you and your folks got enough to eat. You certainly didn't take very much. Then she further said that she hoped that Lenzi and her folk means people, and her people means her family, got enough food to eat. You certainly did not take very much. She further said to Lenzi that you people did not eat much. You took only little bit. You have not taken much of the food. Mom never tries to figure out how much food is prepared. She just puts everything on the table and hopes for the best. So Meg said to Lenzi that her mother does not figure out. Figure out means to discover. She does not discover how much food to make. What she does, she just puts everything on the table. She is a very generous lady, and generously she puts everything on the table and she hopes that everything will be best. I began to relax. The Gleason's dinner party wasn't so different from a Chinese meal after all. So now Lenzi felt relaxed. She was relieved to hear that, and she also felt that the party of Americans and that of Chinese people is not different. My mother also puts everything on the table and hopes for the best. In what sense it was not different? Lenzi's mother also used to put everything on the table when she used to invite the guest, and she used to hope for the best as Meg's mother. So that was the similarity between Lindsay's mother and Meg's mother. That is between American woman and Chinese woman. Meg was the first friend I had made after we came to America. I eventually got acquainted with a few other kids in school, but Meg was still the only real friend I had. So when Lindsay came to America, the first friend which she made was Meg. Meg was her first friend. She got acquainted with many other kids. Acquainted means knowing somebody. She knew other girls also, but she did not know them closer. So the closer friend was only Meg. You can call her her best friend. Like you people, see, in your class there are many students, but all are not your best friends, isn't it? So similarly, here Meg was Lindsay's best friend. The day came when my parents announced that they wanted to give a dinner party. So one day, Lindsay's parents also announced to give the dinner party. We had invited Chinese friends to eat with us before, but this dinner was going to be different. In addition, we were going to invite the Gleasons. Now, it was not for the first time that they were giving any party or they were throwing any party. Before that also, they had invited many Chinese people for party, but this party was going to be different. Why it was going to be different? Because this time they were also going to invite Gleasons who were Americans. I can hardly wait to have dinner at your house, Meg said to me. I just love Chinese food. So when Meg came to know about the party, at that time she was very much excited because she loved Chinese food very much, and she said that she could hardly wait to have dinner at their house. So she was very much eager to have dinner at Lindsay's house. Who was eager? Meg. So Meg was eager to have dinner at Lindsay's house as she loved Chinese food a lot. That was a relief. Mother was a good cook, but I wasn't sure if people who ate sour cream would also eat soy sauce. Now, Lindsay's mother was also a very good cook. She also used to prepare delicious dishes. But here now, Lindsay was not sure whether her American friend and their family would like soy sauce instead of sour cream. Now, Americans eat sour cream. So the people who eat sour cream, would they like to eat soy sauce? That was the question before Lindsay. She was not sure about it. Mother decided not to take a chance. Since we had Western guests, she set the table with the large dinner plates which we never used in Chinese meals. Now, Lindsay's mother did not want to take any chance. She also wanted to serve the best to the guest because for the first time she had invited Americans for dinner. And so, she served the dishes in large platters. Chinese people, they did not use these large platters to serve the food. But as they invited the Americans, she tried to serve them in platters. In fact, we didn't use individual plates at all, but picked up food from the platters in the middle of the table and brought it directly to our rice bowls. So now Chinese people, they did not have individual plates. What they did, they used to take the food from the platters directly into their meal bowls, and then they used to eat it. Following the practice of Chinese American restaurants, mother also placed large serving spoons on the platters. So following the American and Chinese culture, there was a combination of American and Chinese culture. So following this culture, Lenzi's mother placed some serving spoons on the table or on the platters. The dinner started well. Mrs. Gleason exclaimed at the beautifully arranged dishes of food. Now the beginning of dinner was good, and Mrs. Gleason appreciated for the beautiful arrangement of the dishes. At first, I was too busy enjoying my food to notice how the guests were doing. So when the food was served, at that time, Lenzi was busy enjoying her food and she did not notice how other guests were doing, whether they were eating properly or not, whether they needed something or not. She did not pay any heed to them. She was so busy in eating her food. But soon I remembered my duties. Sometimes guests were too polite to help themselves and you had to serve them with more food. So, but after some time, she remembered her duties as a host. She was the host and she remembered that she has to serve the guest. Some of the guests were very polite and the host need to serve them. So she remembered all these things and she decided to serve the people or to pay attention towards the guest. I glanced at Meg to see if she needed more food. So now here Lenzi glanced. Glanced means take a look quickly. She quickly looked at Meg whether she needed some more food to eat. So she wanted to know whether her friend wanted something more. And my eyes nearly popped out at the sight of her plate. And her eyes suddenly popped out at the sight of her plate. Now popped out means to come out suddenly or quick. Suddenly she took a glance at her plate. It was piled with food. So Meg's plate was piled with food. There was lot of food in her plate. She had been taking food from a second dish before she had eating her helping from the first. So whatever she had taken earlier, before finishing that, she took the food from the second dish. And because of that, there was a pile or a heap of food in her plate. Let's move ahead. Horrified, I turned to look at Mrs. Gleason. He was chasing a pea around his plate. Several times he got it to the edge, but when he tried to pick it up, his chopsticks, it rolled back towards the center of the plate again. Finally, he put down his chopsticks and picked up the pea with his fingers. He really did, a grown man. So now, Lenzi was horrified. Why was she horrified? She was horrified to see that Mr. Gleason was chasing a pea around his plate. Chasing a pea. Here now it means Mr. Gleason was trying to pick the pea from his plate with the help of chopsticks. Now, Americans never use chopsticks while eating. They use fork, isn't it? But Chinese people, they eat with chopsticks. And Mr. Gleason was American, he did not have the habit of eating with chopsticks. So, while picking the pea with
the chopstick. Whenever it came at the edge, we used to try to pick it up. Again, it used to come to the center. So he was unable to eat with chopstick. And at this incident, Nancy was horrified. She was filled with horror. And then finally, what he did, he put the chopsticks down and he picked the pea with his fingers.
Finally, he put down his chopsticks and picked up the pea with his fingers. He really did, a grown man.
So he really did that. Even though there were many guests, all most of them were Chinese. But in front of all, he left the chopsticks aside and he picked the pea with his fingers, even though he was a grown-up man.
All of us, our family and the Chinese guests, stop eating to watch the activities of the Gleasons.
Now all of them, means all the members of Lin family and the other Chinese guests, all of them started to look at Gleason's family and their activities, what they were doing, how they were eating. So see, do you remember the same thing happened with Lin's also when they were given celery at Gleason's party? So at that time also, all the Americans were staring at Lin's, and now here all the Chinese people, they were staring at Gleason's family.
I wanted to giggle, then I caught my mother's eyes on me.
So here now, I means who here? Nancy. She wanted to giggle. Giggle means to laugh silly. So she wanted to laugh at this incident, but she looked at her mother. Her mother was staring at her and she made some sign with her eyes, and means she said that not to laugh.
She frowned and shook her head slightly, and I understood the message. She frowned. Frowned means wrinkled the forehead in disapproval.
So when Lacey was about to laugh, her mother frowned. Frowned means she had wrinkles on her forehead, which showed that she did not like the way Nancy is going to behave. So in disapproval, she frowned her forehead, and I understood the message. So looking at this, Nancy understood the message the mother wanted to give her.
The Gleasons were not used to Chinese ways and they were just coping the best they could.
So now here Gleasons, they were not used to the Chinese way of eating. As Gleasons were not used to about the American ways, similarly Gleasons were not used to the Chinese way of eating. But they were trying their best to cope up with that.
For some reason, I thought of celery strings.
So at that time, Nancy remembered about the celery strings, means how they were pulling, and because of that, all the guests were staring at them. So she remembered that incident.
When the main course were finished, mother brought out a platter of fruit. "I hope you weren't expecting a sweet dessert," she said.
So after the dinner was served, after the dinner was finished, Nancy's mother brought a platter of fruits. And she said to Gleasons that she hoped that they were not expecting any desserts, because Chinese people do not eat dessert after dinner.
"I hope you weren't expecting a sweet dessert," she said. "Since the Chinese don't eat dessert, I did not think it to prepare any."
So she said that as we Chinese people, we don't eat dessert. So she did not prepare any dessert. And she hoped that Gleasons would not mind it. Oh, I couldn't possibly eat dessert, cried Mrs. Gleason. I'm simply stuffed. So Mrs. Gleason said, no, now I'm not able to eat any kind of dessert because she was simply stuffed. Her tummy was totally filled with food. Meg had different ideas. When the table was cleared, she announced that she and I were going for a walk. I don't know about you, but I feel like dessert, she told me when we were outside. So after serving the platter of fruits, when everything was done, the table was cleared. So when the table was cleared, Meg announced, she declared that she and Lindsay were going out for a walk. So after going out for a walk, Meg told to her friend Lindsay that she wanted some dessert. Come on, there's a Dairy Queen down the street. I could use a big chocolate milkshake. So Lindsay said that, okay, let's go to the Dairy Queen, which is down the street, and there they could take some chocolate milkshake. Although I didn't really want anything more to eat, I insisted on paying for the milkshakes. Now already Lindsay did not want to eat anymore. She was also filled, but she insisted that she would pay the money for the milkshakes. After all, I was still hostess. So why she wanted to pay the money? Because she was the hostess of the dinner party. Meg got her large chocolate milkshake and I had a small one. Now already Lindsay was full, so she took a small glass of milkshake, whereas Meg took a big glass of milkshake. Even so, she was finishing hers while I was only half done. So Meg was about to finish her milkshake even though she had bigger glass, but Lindsay had finished only half even though she had a smaller glass. Toward the end, she pulled hard on her straws and went slurp slurp. So at the end, when only little milkshake was left in the glass, she pulled hard the straw and she made the slurp slurp sound. So see, whenever you drink some juice with a straw, and if little bit, or you drink the fruity from the box, so when little amount of it is remaining and you try to pull it with the straw, some sort of noise is produced, that is slurp. Okay, do you always slurp when you eat a milkshake? I asked before I could stop myself. So Lindsay, she asked Meg whether she slurps all the time whenever she eats milkshake. Now see here, actually we say we drink milkshake, not eat milkshake. But here the word eat is used for milkshake. Why is it so? Because here also you can see the different culture. There was a different culture of in some people say drink milkshake, and in some countries they say eat milkshake. So that is also the difference of culture. Meg grinned. Sure, all Americans slur. So Meg grinned. Grinned means smile broadly. So when Lindsay asked whether she slurped all the time when she ate milkshake, at that time Meg had a broad smile on her face and with her smiling face said, yeah, sure, because all Americans slurp. So whenever Americans used to drink something, they used to slurp. Slurp means to make a noise while drinking something. So from this lesson, what message do you get? The message is that we should accept others' culture. We should not laugh at their culture. If some person, he comes to you with, who belongs to different culture, so we should adjust with him. We should try to make him feel comfortable and adjustable with us. So that is the moral or the lesson we get through this lesson. Okay. Now let's discuss the MCQs. The first one, the one thing that the narrator and her family found difficult in the early days was. So what was the one thing which was difficult for narrator in the early days when they shifted from China to America? Option A, speaking the language. Option B, acquiring a house. Option C, American table manners. Or option D, making a new friends. So the correct answer is option C, American table manners. They found it hard to adjust with American table manners, isn't it? Second one, the narrator's family did not dip their celery into the sour cream because. Now why they did not dip their celery into sour cream? Option A, there was not too much of it. No, because there was lot of dip in the relish tray. It was spoiled. Obviously not, as it was served for the guest, it was not spoiled. Option C, they did not like the dairy products. Or option D, they were feeling shy. So, option C, they did not like the dairy products. Question number 3, we can tell that the narrator and her family were not used to a buffet meal because. So how we can say that the narrator and her family was not used to buffet system? Option A, they started to serve the others. No, they did not start. Option B, they refused to eat. No. Option C, they took away the serving dish. No. Option D, they took chairs to the table. Yes, they took chairs to the table. There were no chairs around the table. So they took, carried some chairs near the table. So option D is the correct answer. Next, question number 4. At the Chinese dinner, the narrator was shocked when he saw. So at Chinese dinner, why was the narrator shocked? What did she see? People laugh at lessons. Option B, her mother shake her head. Option C, makes plate with food from both the dishes. Or option D, Mrs. Gleason eat with her hands. Option C is the correct answer. Makes plate with food from both the dishes. So I hope you have understood the lesson. Thank you.